Let's take a look at what it means to maintain your RV.
Hey everyone, I am Ian Baker and I am joined today by Tom Wirtala. Tom works for us here at Camping World. He is a master certified technician and also an instructor at the Camping World Technical Institute. Tom, thank you so much for being here today. And I asked Tom to be here today because we're going to talk a little bit about RV maintenance. With so many people coming into the RV lifestyle, which I absolutely love, people want to know how to protect their investment. And there's some things you have to do every so often, you know, every trip or every 3 months or 6 months or annually, whatever it may be. So I have Tom here to kind of walk us through some of those basics to make sure that your RV stays in tip-top shape for years to come. So Tom, take it away, my friend.
Well, we're going to start with what you do every trip. No matter what, you're going to check the air pressure in your tires. The number one reason for blowouts is low air pressure, and do it according to manufacturer specifications of the RV, not the tire.
Okay.
And make sure every time you get a chance to get the air pressure.
Okay.
If not, get a sensor that automatically tells you and sends it to your phone, like
okay.
Our cars do, right?
Yeah.
Our car tells me when I got low air pressure. There's a reason for that.
Okay.
So if it's brand new, after the first 500 miles or so, according to the sticker that's on the side, it's torqued the lug nuts.
Okay.
Manufacturer specifications, get those lug nuts torqued after your first trip.
Because that will change from RV to RV a little bit, right? Depending on the size of the tire, whatever it may be, can be a little bit different.
Most definitely. Most regular RV travel trailers is somewhere between 100 and 120 foot-pounds. You need a special tool to do it. Any tire manufacturer or where you'd buy your tires,
sure,
torque your lug nuts for you. Pretty simple. It won't charge you much. Bring it back to the dealer.
Absolutely.
You're going to get maintenance done, but we should be watching those lug nuts.
Okay.
And trailers especially, because we're dragging them around.
Absolutely.
And they're loosening up.
People don't understand how quickly that weight starts to add up, and suddenly you have a blowout, and it's, you know, smacking the underbelly, doing some damage, nothing that you ever want to have happen. So every trip, make sure we're checking those tires. I like that.
So that's number one. The next thing you want to be checking is all your DOT stuff, Department of Transportation.
Okay.
So you don't want to be towing and not have brake lights. So every time you hook up, you're going to be checking those lights every time you get a chance. There's a plug there that can come out at any time.
Okay.
So make sure you do that. We're going to, before the trip, we're going to take some time and clean the RV and give it some minor inspections.
Okay.
We're not going to crawl through it with a fine-tooth comb, but we're looking for major problems.
Okay.
The main thing is getting it clean and getting it washed, especially in the RVs that have the metal siding like the one behind us, is we end up with things called black streaks, which is just dirt that's been on the roof. We get the rain, it comes down. Those black streaks get on there, they don't come off.
Okay.
If you wash it all the time, every time before a major trip, because you just spent 5 hours packing for the trip, why don't we just take the afternoon and give it a quick bath?
I love it.
I love to use stuff like wash and wax.
Okay.
It's all in one. That way I get it good and clean. It gives it a little shine too.
It's kind of like my shampoo and conditioner in one, right?
All in one, yeah. And make sure you get that in a gallon too. So it's all in one. Before, and I definitely would do it after a trip too. Why would you park your RV in your driveway or in storage all dirty?
Yes. Now we talk about a black streaks coming down from the roof, right? Now, as far as roof cleaning, I know that that can be a little more laborious.
Most definitely, I would get it done once a year. I'd get it done professionally.
Yes.
The reason is you get a little soap, a little water on that roof, you fall down, you're not going to work. Now you can't make your payments and they come and take your RV away.
Right.
So stay off the roof. Once a year, you can just have it done. Camping World has a thing called an RPM, and they'll wash your roof, and then they'll treat your roof with a UV protector, because we know the sun destroys everything.
Yes.
So if you put a little protector, a little sunscreen on it, you're going to get a lot more years out of your roof. If you have a ladder, you could put the ladder next to the RV and visually inspect the roof.
Okay.
You need to fix and stop the water damage right now.
Yep. All Camping World locations, if you're on a trip, you're driving somewhere, and let's say you need to stop and just pick something up at the store, maybe it's toilet paper, whatever it may be, it's a free service to have someone get up there and check out your roof.
Absolutely. when you're washing it, it's perfect time to get an inspection. Now we're looking at seals around the windows and the doors.
Okay.
So some people go around and inspect it. Well, if I'm washing it and I do it the old fashioned way as high as I can by hand.
All right.
I'm inspecting as I'm washing, right?
Sure.
How many times you wash your car and found, oh my gosh, where did that dent?
Dent, scratch.
Yeah. I mean, do it by hand. I like the brushes that you hook the hose to.
Okay.
So you're literally, when you're getting up high, the water's running through the brush, rinsing, making more suds. You can get it clean pretty easy.
Yeah.
Every 3 months, what I would do is, I've been camping for 3 months and I'm not sure where I was. I'm gonna turn around and sanitize my fresh water system.
Okay, talk to me a little bit about that.
So sanitizing your fresh water system is the water that we're using in the plumbing. In your house, you're always hooked up to your well or the city. You're pretty confident they got water. Well, we're going to campground, it's water sitting in my RV in between trips getting stagnant.
Okay.
If it just has a stagnant smell and it just doesn't smell right because water's been sitting around, stale water.
Sure.
We can just freshen it up with a product like this, which is just, it cleans it up, makes it smell a little better. It's not, anyone been in an RV and get that weird musty smell from the water?
Sure. Yeah.
This is what takes care of it. But what caused that musty smell is my thing.
Okay.
So I'm gonna use a product like a sanitizer.
Okay.
I'm gonna follow the instructions step by step.
Okay.
It says danger. You better follow the instructions. But it's gonna kill anything that possibly might be alive in the water system.
Okay.
So we're gonna put this in the fresh water tank with a mixture. We're gonna let it sit. We're gonna run it through all our faucets, make sure this dilution makes it out of every faucet.
Okay.
And then we're gonna let it sit for 4 hours.
Okay.
That 4 hours is what kills all the bacteria.
All right.
Flush it out when you're done, you know you're clean.
Perfect.
If possible, take your own water. Be careful where you hook up. Don't just get water from a gas station.
Sure.
Honestly, the water at the gas station is for filling up trucks and radiators, and the hose isn't even right. It's an old rubber hose.
Yeah.
Make sure you know where your water's coming from.
Have a safe drinking water hose
You got it.
Yep.
So once we got that all going, let's just start by, when we're at the campground, filter systems.
Okay.
When you're camping, make sure you use a filter system. We don't want any sand or anything inside.
Yeah, all the sediment starting to get into your plumbing, causing problems.
Yep, let's catch the big stuff before it even gets in there, because trying to flush that out later is horrible.
Oh, I bet.
So multiple filters. Yeah, you are going to lose a little water pressure. When,
sure.
You know, that's part of life.
Yeah. Worth it.
The more money you spend on filters, the better water pressure you got, by the way.
Okay.
I found out the more expensive ones work much better. But just a pre-filter to keep the sand out.
What about our black and gray tanks? Do we have to... I mean, I know that if you're RVing, right, you put chemical to help break down toilet paper, things like that. You know, and a lot more RVs have like black tank flush systems on them. What kind of maintenance do we have to do on those tanks, if any?
That's a great question. Start by preventing the problem in the first place.
Okay.
You're only going to use RV toilet paper in an RV. And once we get the toilet paper, I know it's not the nicest stuff. It's you're just gonna have to deal with it because this will break down in the holding tank.
Okay.
Regular toilet paper will just turn into a pyramid and turn into paper mache. The other thing, when you're using a black holding tank, which is body waste, use twice as much water to flush than you ever thought.
Okay.
Everyone's trying to conserve water.
Yep.
Well, if I have a solid to turn it into a liquid, I need to put liquid in there. So flush, maybe double flush.
Okay.
That will, all that extra liquid is going to help break down the tissue.
It's a good tip. I like that.
I'm a firm believer in using chemicals.
Yes.
Not just to control the odor, it helps this break down.
Okay.
So I'm using chemicals every time. In the gray water, which gray water is shower water, sink water, we do have cleaners for that too, because gray water smells like dirty dishwater soap. It's horrible. So
fair enough.
So that's, you need to pour this down the sink.
Yeah.
Fill it up. Keep that smelling good.
Cause I you like don't it.
Wanna, so.
Well, because a lot of the plumbing doesn't have P traps, right? Which like at our home, our house, right? Residential. I guess some of them do, don't they?
They all have a P trap. Otherwise.
Except for the toilet.
Except for the toilet. Toilet has a seal. So if you ever, that's a great question. If you ever get done using the toilet and it closes and a little bit of water is supposed to be sitting on top of that valve, if there is no water on top of that valve holding there, that means the gases are coming up.
Okay.
So in about an hour, your whole camper is going to smell like an outhouse. You need to figure out what's stopping that.
Yeah.
But the sinks all do have P-traps. That brings up a great thing, too. You just came off the interstate. Water sloshes around. When you get to the RV, run water down each sink and fill those P-traps.
Okay.
With holding tanks, you want to flush them out. The manufacturers tell you you should flush it every time. Every time you dump, take the time to flush.
Okay.
The next thing is basically lubing stuff. All your slide rooms, all your rubber, we lubricate the rubber. So slide rooms are in there, it's been out there, it's going to stick.
Okay.
So by cleaning the rubber and conditioning the rubber, all that rubber won't stick.
Okay.
Everything will work much, much better. So conditioning, cleaning first, and then conditioning the rubber. Everyone asks me about slide rooms. So I got to lube them. And I'm doing this every season. You only lubricate according to manufacturer specifications.
Okay.
And most of them want no lubricant at all, believe it or not.
I do believe that.
So you have a slide room, it squeaks.
You
want to lubricate what's squeaking. That means find out the one little spot it's squeaking and one squirt.
Okay.
We do not cover everything with oil.
All right.
We do have stuff like slide out dry lube, which protects metal parts from rusting and that, things that are rubbing past. And the reason I say not lube is there's not a lot of metal on metal that we need to lubricate. They have other pieces of plastic.
Sure.
So
that makes
just
sense.
A little bit of lube.
And okay.
Do your research. Find out. There's a lot of them out there who want no lubrication at all.
Okay. And now, what about annually? Are there just things to bring in, have it checked out annually, or?
Every year, you need to bring it in and get the bearings packed if it's a travel trailer.
Okay.
They need to be done every year. We cannot see the brakes. We don't know how much you've been driving. Time, moisture gets in the bearings and might ruin the bearings. So every year, have your bearings packed, have your brakes adjusted.
Okay.
That's every year. The other thing I would definitely recommend is have a maintenance done on all your appliances before you put it in storage, which I prefer, or after coming out. We need to keep all our appliances working so when we go RVing, we don't have any problems. That means furnace, water heater, air conditioners. We need to clean our air conditioners to get them to work properly. People in the summer say, air conditioner isn't working. We didn't service it, so it's dirty. All we had to do is clean it once a year, and we would be fine.
Now, is that a service that Camping World offers as well if they want to bring their RV in?
Most definitely.
Perfect.
Camping World, and that's why I like before, when you take it out, we have plenty of time. I can drop it off, leave it there. They can do my services. They can recommend, call me, and I'll fix or do what they
service they need to do.
You let the professionals guide you.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's in your manuals. If you don't trust the guy at the service counter, you all know
he's
that.
He's lying to me.
He's trying to sell me a Knutson valve, and I can't find that on Google.
Headlamp fluid.
We just open up the owner's manual of the RV, and it's going to recommend everything we need to do.
Perfect. Well, Tom, I thank you so much for kind of walking everyone through. As you can see, there is definitely some maintenance we want to make sure we do. And it sounds like if someone's uncomfortable doing it, whether it's working on the AC or getting up on the roof, they can always bring it to a Camping World. We'll make sure it's professionally done.
Perfect.
Awesome. Thanks, Tom. Appreciate it.
Welcome.